Q92, it's Annie in the Morning with Ryan. There's something really special that we kicked off. It's called Caring for Our Community. And our Caring for Our Community partner is Ulster Savings Bank. When it comes to celebrating our Warrior of the Week, all the community events that we do pretty much on the daily here at Q92. And we're so honored to have the president and CEO of Ulster Savings Bank on with us this morning, Bill Calderara. Good morning, Bill.
Good morning, Ann. Good morning, Ryan. Happy to be here.
You do a lot for the community at Ulster Savings Bank.
We do. We've been in the community for, we're actually celebrating our 170th anniversary.
Wow.
So we've talked about that a little bit, but we're a mutual community bank. And the mutuality part of that means we have no shareholders. Our founders founded us really as a philanthropic institution. We were founded for the benefit of our customers and the community at large. If you think about it, they put up their own money years ago to form a bank because they thought they needed a community without any expectation of ever getting that money back or ever getting return on that money. So we take that to heart. That's part of our DNA. And we take a good part of our annual profits and give it back out into the community in donations. And last year, because the need was so great because of COVID, we actually even increased that. So it was just under $600,000.
Wow.
That we gave out last year in grants. And we're probably somewhere close to $14 million since we formed our foundation, which was only back in 2001. I don't know how much the bank has given in its whole, it's 170 years is much more than that.
That is absolutely incredible. Amazing job. Yes. And as you mentioned, during a pandemic, and not only just raising the money to give back to the community, but can we acknowledge for a second that I feel like people that work at banks, and especially Ulster Savings Bank, you guys are considered like essential workers. And the fact that you worked through the pandemic to make sure that all of our finances were handled, you never shut down. Thank you for that as well.
Well, thank you. We do. So giving back to the community for us also involves not just donating our money, which is important, but donating our time. And I got to give kudos to our employees. We have a goal that 100% of our employees volunteer within the community each year. That's to a tune of usually around 10,000 man hours a year that they give back into the community in various different pieces. So it's not just the money that we give. We also want to be part of that community, and that's really important to us as well.
The thing about Q92 that Ryan and I love so much about working here is we do a lot with so many organizations. Each week we do the Warrior of the Week, where we honor just exceptional human beings, people that have overcome adversity. They've created, a not-for-profit in their community. And the fact that you're partnering with us on that and acknowledging these people is just incredible. So thank you for that. Again, it's our Caring for Our Community partner, Ulster Savings Bank. So is there anything else going on with Ulster Savings Bank that you want to tell us about? Like, what's going on at the different branches?
Well, one of the things I wanted to mention is, we are celebrating our 170th anniversary. It's actually April 12th, so it's coming up in a few days. It was actually our founding day in 1851. And we were trying to think of what else we could do this year to be special to give back to the community. And again, because we already give out so much in the form of donations, making some type of announcement that we were going to give out $170,000 really didn't make a lot of sense because it would be less than we have given in prior years. So what we decided to come up with was something that we talked about, and we're doing 170 acts of kindness, random kindness throughout the community. Just interesting things like we've gone into coffee houses and we've paid for coffee for a day for all the customers we've worked with pizzerias and given out random customers who've been able to get free pizzas. We've worked with a sanitation company that actually some of their customers were having difficulty financially because of the pandemic and weren't able to pay their bills, and we picked up all of the bills for them. So just flowers for Valentine's Day with the different pieces. We've gone out and just seen people that were online in a grocery store and decided to randomly pay for their groceries, randomly pay for dinners and restaurants. So we're just having some fun with it, and we thought it was a great way to celebrate our 170th anniversary. So
that is absolutely amazing. The feeling you get when you do a random act of kindness is tremendous, and to know that you guys, and you can tell in the way you're speaking about it, how much fun you guys are having, and 170, that's a lot,
yeah,
but you've been around a lot, so you got to do it.
We've made up like a little business card that just says honoring our anniversary with 170 acts of kindness that we hand out when we do the service. So it's just something we thought was different and we'd have some fun with, and we're really hoping that it's a kind of a pass on type of a a program that when someone receives one, maybe they'll pay it forward, and we can help our whole community that way.
Everybody get out there, do a random act of kindness, just like Ulster Savings Bank is doing. Bill, thank you so much for joining us, and thank you so much for being a Caring for Our Community partner.
Well, thank you. We appreciate it, and we're happy to do it. We love our veterans as well, so we really do like honoring them.
Yes, thank you again. And Mike Post is up next with his Daily Dose, some sad news in the music world. He has it all covered for you next on Q92.